Hello guys, today we are going to see the solution for Larry's array, which is a medium level problem on HackerRank. The question states that there is an array of integers and we have to perform rotation operation on any three consecutive integers any number of times to see if it is ever possible to get a sorted array. The order of rotation is as follows. Pick the first number and put it at the end every time you perform a rotation operation. Now let's see what is happening in this rotation. Let's see if we have three integers 3, 1 and 2. Now if we put 3 after 1 and 2, we will get 1, 2, 3, which is a sorted array. The number in parentheses indicate the problematic relationships. 3 has two problematic relationship because 3 is greater than 1 and 3 is greater than 2. We want a sorted array in which the next number should always be smaller than the previous number. For 1, there is no problematic relationship because the next number, which is 2, is greater than 1. Now coming to the second array, 1, 3 and 2. 1 has no problematic relationship. 3 has one problematic relationship because 2 is smaller than 3 and 2 has no problematic relationship. Now if we put 1 after 3 and 2, we will get 3, 2, 1, which is not the required result. Now we again rotate it, put 3 after 2 and 1, we will get 2, 1 and 3. No matter how many times we rotate, we will never get a sorted array in this condition. Now coming to the third array, 2, 3 and 1. We can see there is one problematic relationship for 2 because 1 is smaller than 2. There is one problematic relationship for 3 because 1 is smaller than 3. Now we rotate it once and put 2 after 3 and 1, we will get 3, 1, 2. Now we can say 1 and 2 are in sorted order, but 3 is having problematic relationship with both 1 and 2. Now we again rotate it. So we will get 1, 2 and 3, which is the sorted array. The important thing to notice here is that every time we rotate, there are two relationships which will be changing. Like in the first array, 3, 1 and 2, when we rotate 3 after 1 and 2, the relationship of 3 changed with 1 and relationship of 3 changed with 2, and it comes in a sorted order. In second array, 1, 3 and 2, when we put 1 after 3 and 2, the relationship of 1 changed with both 3 and 2, and in subsequent rotations, the integer which we are picking up and putting it end, the relationship of that integer is changing with the other two. So every time two relations are changing. So in second case, there was only one problematic relationship. It means whenever we are performing rotation operation, even if we are solving one problematic relation, we are always creating the other problematic relation because two relations are changing every time we are performing a rotation operation. One more important point to note here is that any number which is before this subset of three integers and any numbers which are after this subset of three integers will not have any effect on relationship by this rotation operation. Now let's try to see the example given by HackerRank. There is an array 1, 6, 5, 2, 4, 3. So we can see there are 0 problematic relationships for 1, 4 problematic relationships for 6 because there are 4 smaller numbers after 6, 5, 2, 4 and 3. There are 3 problematic relationships for 5 because there are 3 smaller numbers after 5. For 2, there is no problematic relationship because both numbers 4 and 3 are greater than 2. For 4, there is one problematic relationship because 3 is smaller than 4. Now we perform rotation on 6, 5 and 2. So we put 5, 2, 6 in place of 6, 5, 2. And we can see, as we discussed earlier, the effect of relationship on 1, 4 and 3, which are the numbers outside of this subset, will have no effect on relationships. But the relationships of 5, 2 and 6 underwent change. For 6, there were 4 problematic relations which have now become 2. For 5, there were 3 problematic relations which remain same. For 2, the problematic relations remain same. In the next iteration, we again rotated 5, 2 and 6. So it becomes 1, 2, 6, 5, 4, 3. The relationships changed for 6 and 5. Now if we keep on performing these rotations, we will finally able to get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, which is the sorted array. Now we again have to look at the total number of problematic relationships in each iteration. In first iteration, we can see there were 4, 3 and 1, total of 8 problematic relationships. In second iteration, we can see there were total of 3 plus 2 plus 1, 6 problematic relationships. Here there are total of 3 plus 2 plus 1, 6 problematic relationships. Here we can see 3 plus 1, 4 problematic relationships. Here we can see 1 plus 1, 2 problematic relations. And there are 0 problematic relations and we get a sorted array. So we can say that the relationships are changing in pairs. So if total number of problematic relations is divisible by 2, then we can say that it is possible for the array to be presented in a sorted manner. But if the total number of problematic relations is not a multiple of 2, we will never get a sorted array. Now we simply have to put this in a code. So what we need? We need firstly the sum of problematic relations, which we'll get by 1 for I ring. Now what I have put here is that for I in range len A and for J in range I plus 1 to the remaining length, if the preceding number is greater than the following number, then those are the problematic relations and give 1 for those relations. And if we sum all these numbers and if we take percentage 2 and if it is 1, then we want know that the array cannot be sorted, and if it is 0, then we can say that the array can be sorted. So we simply have to write return know if exists, if this sum exists, else simply return yes. Thank you guys for watching and keep practicing.